Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Okay, here I am back in this Tyler Hobson original Penguin Chest Fest. And I thought the 10 pack went pretty well. You know, I came out of the hole pretty clean, then bang, two, boom, boom. And I sort of felt good. I was animal enough to kill it. I actually feel like I surpassed the 10 rep range on that 10 pack. So, yeah, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to go ahead and say the hell with it and just make the 45 pound jump up to a 12 pack and not waste any more energy, explosive energy on, and just a 25, a 5 and a 25 on each side. I'm just going to go straight to 12 pack, which is, to me, that, you know, 12 pack on this machine really puts you in the stratosphere as far as handling massive resistance on this machine. It's just not a common thing to do, and you're never going to see it again. You're only going to see it here. Now, I'm sure there's guys out there that can go ahead and bang this 12-pack. Yeah, that's for sure. There's a lot of strong guys out there. I'm not the strongest guy on the internet, but I'd like to see it. So, I'm going to go ahead and try for 4 repetitions on this again, and I would love to do it. I would love to get it done. You know, last time, like I said, when I reviewed the video, I think I got around 2 successful, 3 at 60 to 80, and then 4 as a partial. So it's all on how I can get out of the hole and how my wrists are on here and how I feel. The last time I did this 12-pack, I had my elbow supports on. And again, I had to cut those elbow supports to get them on. I'm very uncomfortable to get on. I'm electing not to put my elbow supports on. I don't think the elbow supports really give you any jump out of the hole. They're just more or less trying to protect my elbows, keep them warm, keep the joint warm. But my elbows feel pretty good right now. So I'm going to go ahead and try to bang this 12-pack out again. It's going to be a pretty rough set. I'm going to have to get really, really animal on this. It's not going to be a pretty set. Nah, it depends what your idea of pretty is. I think it's going to be a pretty set. It's going to be a pretty awesome set. So that's the way we're going to get it done. Now, the last time I did a 10-pack on this machine, I called my good buddy TJ Lynch out of Jersey. He has the exact same machine. And I said, hey, brother, I busted out 10-pack on this. Ha, ha, ha. You know, I got your ass on this. So a few days later, he texted me a video on my phone of him busting out 10-pack. Pretty competitive guy, huh? Said, okay, man, I'm going to show you my bust out 12-pack. Let's see if you can go up to that. But what I noticed on his video, when he sent me my videos, because I was studying his technique on the video, because he's had the machine a lot longer than me, and his performance is, his technique's pretty good on this machine. And I noticed how he got in the machine, how he placed his body positioning in the machine. He actually put his feet back behind like this. Normally, I'm out like this, pushing. So he had his feet back behind like this, and that's going to give him a nice, more natural arch, a natural spring arch, and that's really what you want. So I text him back, you know, an awesome set, that's pretty good, and I'm going to steal your technique. That's what I'm going to do, and see if that helps me. So I really like the fact he sent me that video, and I got to study it, and I got to see how he put his feet back on there. So that's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to put my feet back on here. That's why I got this set wide. I want you to see the whole technique. I want you to see the whole machine. I want you to see the whole me, and I want you to see what goes down when you attempt this shit. So right now I got Godsmack Realign. Now that really gets me going. I love that song, Godsmack Realign. After I do this set, I may need to be realigned. So we're gonna find out. So I gotta get on it. So 4 repetition, boom! It'd be awesome for me, man. I feel really high off that. I feel good. I should be able to beat my performance on the last set. You know, I feel pretty good. But it all depends on how well I'm warmed up. I warmed up a little more, but I may have warmed up too excessively last time. So let's see. Let's see on this. I'm going to go ahead and turn my Bluetooth on now and get some realign jamming and get my mind all wrapped around this and try to give you guys a stellar performance on this and a stellar performance for me. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Come on! Come on! So I tripled it, and I got about 80% of the fourth. That kind of upsets me. It kind of makes me feel good, but I'm kind of pissed I couldn't get at least into the 90% range on that last lockout on that fourth rep, man. So, that's kind of funny, man. I feel that way. But that's, like I said, that's the tough guy I am, man. And that set was more successful than my last attempt at this. It felt good coming out of the hole, man. When I came out of the hole, I actually thought, man, I'm going to be right in there, man. I'm going to be right in there, you know, on that 3 or 4 rep range. I could feel it. But then again, you know, this machine, because it's a leverage style machine, as you're pushing, the weight is rising, and as the weight is rising, you're not really getting any reprieve, you know, from the tension. You got to get through your lockout, and you got to keep forcing the weight up. So, because you can see, when I got to about 80% on that fourth repetition, you know, on a normal type bench or a normal type machine, you're nailing it at that, man. You're at 80%, you can't through your lockout like that. Boom, you shouldn't have any sticking points. You should just cruise right through. Really, really good. But on here, man, you know, the tension just keeps picking up. So it's a little more difficult on getting lockout on here. So I'm not trying to make excuses for not killing the 4 of a 12 pack. That's just the way it is on this machine. I know that's the way it is on this machine. I knew I was going to encounter that. And I should be happy about that. But, you know, I'm probably going to have to get back on this machine again, damn it, in a couple weeks to really, truly bang that damn 6 pack on each side, or 12 pack. But that was a good set. That was an internet record set. That was smashing this machine set. So I shouldn't be, you know, too upset with myself. But, you know, that's the way I get, you know, when I... Yeah, I envision doing this. Actually, you know, before I fall asleep, I sort of envision what I'm going to do the next day when I'm training. And I was really thinking about this, about how I felt, and going up those 6-pack and showing you guys, you know, how to kick ass on that. I knew I had extra power. If you look at my legs videos yesterday on the Medics Avenger leg press, I was killing it, man. I was killing it on there as far as leg power. So I knew I had to build up a more power. And now whether that power can transfer over from the lower body to the upper, often it doesn't. You can be stronger on the lower, stronger on the upper, but it doesn't actually correlate to an all-around power because they're different movements. So, but I knew I was stronger. I knew I had a good chance to go ahead and get in 4 of this. And when I look at the video, I'm probably going to say, man, I nailed 4. I was very, very close. I still feel it on my chest. I can still feel it on the upper pec. You know, while I'm sitting here talking, while I'm resting, and my chest is relaxing. I can totally feel that. So I'm going to count that as my first set. Following the first law of hypertrophy, and that is using max resistance for your desired number of repetitions. And my rep range always on chest is 4. So